Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 69 of our Golang course. In this lesson, we are going to touch upon difference between concurrency and parallelism, along with Go's philosophy and inspiration for concurrent programming. This will help you understand the concept of concurrency more clearly and have a concurrency programming mindset. So, let's get started. First, let us see what's the difference between concurrency and parallelism. Concurrency is about running multiple tasks. Now, these tasks may or may not run in parallel. For example, on a single core processor, if you are running multiple processes, the processes will be executed sequentially by CPU with the help of context switching, but it is done so fast that it may give an illusion that processes are running in parallel. Parallelism, on the other hand, is the actual execution of multiple tasks simultaneously. On a multiple core processor, each process can run on a single CPU core, as such, running in a truly parallel sense. With this, your program will have significant performance gains. In a sense, concurrency is a broader concept that can be achieved with or without parallelism. Parallelism is a specific type of concurrency that leverages multiple processing units for true simultaneous execution. Depending on the context in which you are running, concurrency can or cannot be parallelism. Now let us discuss the challenges of concurrent programming and Go's approach to concurrency. Writing concurrent programs correctly can be tricky. Traditionally, you focus on threads and shared memory, which can lead to complex code and potential race condition. This is because in most operating systems and languages, the level of abstraction for concurrent programming don't provide ideal tool for managing these complexities. Go offers a different approach inspired by CSP or Communicating Sequential Processes, a concept from paper by the same name. This approach simplifies concurrency by focusing on communicating between lightweight processes called coroutines. This also simplifies the thinking around concurrent programming. If you think about programming is a sequence of operations where each function accepts an input and provides an output, which is consumed as an input by other functions, and then they too provide an output. Instead of thinking concurrency with thread management, thinking it in the context of sequential processing, it makes it easier to write concurrent programming. As such, Go has been really successful with concurrency. Now let us talk briefly about coroutines and channels, which we will dive deeper into in the following lessons. Goroutines. These are lightweight threads managed by the Go runtime. So, you don't need to worry about low-level thread management. This allows you to write more natural concurrent code. In Go, channels act as typed communication pipelines between Go routines. So, think about the sequential flow. Channels help us do that. Data flows from channels, enabling Go routine exchange information without complex synchronization techniques like other languages. The Go runtime, which is embedded in the binary that you build, takes care of scheduling Go routines into available CPU cores or the OS threads. If one Go routine is blocked, example waiting for I/O, the runtime can switch to another Go routine, improving overall application responsiveness. So, this is an added layer of encapsulation which helps you write concurrent program more easily. Channels can be combined into various ways to build complex concurrent programs. As we have already covered, channels facilitate the communication between two Go routines, enabling data exchange. You can also merge data streams from multiple Go routines into a single channel, which helps processing a program in parallel depending on the context, and then combining the output. Channels can be used with timeout and cancellation and communication with other system, which helps you manage the communication between two Go routines. Another cool feature of Go is the select statement. The select statement, another concept borrowed from CSP, provides a powerful mechanism for managing channels. It helps you wait for events. You can use select to wait for data to be available on a channel. Select also allows you choosing data from first channel that becomes ready and do the processing. Go also takes inspiration from guarded statement, which we will see when working with channels. With all that we have seen, It doesn't mean that Go doesn't provide any primitives or any traditional primitives for writing concurrent program. As we have seen in previous examples, Go's sync package offers traditional concurrency primitives like mutexes and atomic operations. While channels and Go routines are preferred for most cases, the sync package provides additional tools when needed. For example, guarding against a field in a struct like we saw with the counter. In that case, you would use a mutex for synchronization. In the next lesson, we will look deeper into the Go routines and the runtime for scheduling the Go routines. As discussed in this lesson, Go empowers developers to choose the most appropriate concurrency primitives for their specific needs. Channels and Go routines are preferred for natural and efficient communication, while the sync package provides additional control when necessary. I know it has been a dry lesson with no coding examples, but we need to go over the theory to make sure that we understand Go programming language syntax for concurrent programming. That's it for the lesson. If you have any questions, please feel free to post a comment under the video or reaching out to our Discord server. I will see you in the next lesson. Until then, happy coding.